baby. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I have a super exciting video. So if you wanna know all about my top recommendations for the Sephora spring sale and some of the goodies that I'm actually gonna be buying, please keep watching. So if you have been following my channel for all of 2021, you will know that I have been anxiously awaiting the Sephora sale since actually probably December. I have been so excited for this sale. If you followed me for years, you know that I used to be a bit of a shopaholic. So as part of my mission to stop shopping so much, I told myself I was only really going to buy a lot of beauty products when Sephora has their sale 2 times a year. So you guys will notice now I don't do too many hauls on my channel because I like to save my shopping for when I can get the best deal. And I don't wanna just buy. Because first of all, I don't have space for 100 new products every other month. And also I just don't need it. So I really only shop twice a year when Sephora has their large sales. And I am so excited for Sephora's spring sale. I also want to announce that this video is being made in collaboration with Magiclinks. Now, Magiclinks is one of my favorite websites. If you are a creator, if you're creative, if you share, if you blog, anything of the sort, Magiclinks is a website that is used to link products for you guys. And we do get a small commission from those purchases. It's just a nice thank you to the people sharing the products that you all purchase. It doesn't cost you anything extra and you don't have to purchase through my links, but it's always appreciated because it helps me reinvest in my channel. So thank you so much to Magiclinks for sponsoring this video because I use Magiclinks all the time and I also shop the Sephora sale. So grateful for this opportunity. So let's get into my top picks for the Sephora spring sale. First things first, if you want all the information, all the codes when the sale starts, I will flash it across the screen. So if you are listening to this video, I urge you to pause it. I will also put all the information in the description box down below. Usually Rouge, VIB, and Beauty Insider have 3 different shopping dates as well as discounts. It's kind of like a tiered system. So the more you spend in a year with Sephora, the more you save. I usually go ham during this sale, so I'm really excited about it. Okay, now on to all the good stuff. The first category of products that I always recommend people buy during this sale is things that they use consistently. So these are items that you may need to stock up on. Your Shiseido cotton squares, your foundations, concealers, your eyebrow pomades, your cleansers, your moisturizers. Anything that you guys use that you constantly replenish, now is the time to save, specifically if you're VIB or Rouge, because you're getting a great discount. Not a lot of times during the year does Sephora offer a chance to save between 15 to 20%. So I love to take advantage. This is the time when I'm going to stock up on all my essentials. And I'm not gonna bore you guys during this video because I will be doing a sale haul of all the goodies that I've purchased. So I've never really organized my video this way, but we're gonna do makeup, skincare, and then fragrance. So I will place timestamps on the screen in case you want to skip around. Maybe you're not into makeup. I totally get it. Besides all of your great staples, the first item on my list is the Fenty Beauty Eavesdrop Blurring Skin Tint. And oh my goodness, you guys, I am so excited about this product. I'm actually going to link 2 videos down below. One from my girl, Simply Aisha, and another one from Brown Girl Luxe. I love those ladies. This is a new item from Fenty Beauty that I want to try, and I'm not sure why, because this is a skin tint. And if you have watched any of my other videos, you will know that I don't have perfected skin like this under my foundation. I definitely have flawed, imperfect skin. I always call it perfectly imperfect because every skin is perfect no matter what. I really want to try out this product. Not that it's made for someone like me. It's pretty much a sheer tinted product that is supposed to mimic the look of natural skin. Clearly, as you can see today, I love a full coverage beat. So not sure if I would like it, but for some reason, I do want to try it. So that is one product that I would highly recommend. Okay, the next product would be the Laura Mercier Loose Translucent Setting Powder. This is a product that I will forever repurchase until I find something a little better, which I will be repurchasing this sale time to see if I like it. But this is what I use today and what I use every day to set my foundation and concealer. I really like a loose translucent setting powder because it seals everything in. I'm oily. Now I did put on highlighter today. I like to look glowy, but I want to be able to choose where I'm glowing. So an all over loose translucent setting powder is amazing. Also, if you have oily skin like your girl, this is going to be your friend. If you are finding that maybe you're watching beauty videos and your makeup doesn't look as airbrushed smooth, you might want to start using a setting powder. It is a game changer. This is something that I started using when I was working in the beauty industry, and I promise day and night, you definitely want to incorporate a setting powder if it works for your skin. I know some people don't use one. Okay, next item is the Merit Shade Slick Tinted Lip Oil, and this is actually a product that I tried out. I was contacted by Merit to do a video on their new line, which is amazing. It's sustainable, it's luxurious, the products are just A1, and it's all about minimalistic beauty. So if you're not like myself and you don't like a full coverage beat, which I understand, I feel like the everyday woman or man really likes a more simplistic makeup look, which I understand, definitely check out Merit Beauty. Now, while a lot of those products aren't necessarily for me in terms of my oily skin and my love of coverage, that lip oil is amazing because it hydrates your lips, it provides a beautiful glow, and you get a sheer wash of color. So I really have enjoyed that. The next item is what I have been obsessed with, and it is the Bite Beauty Upswing eyeliner, and also, well, another item, the Bite Beauty Upswing mascara. You guys, now today I have on falsies. I will link them down below. They are magnetic lashes that I'm obsessed with, but when I'm not wearing my falsies, I love wearing the Bite Upswing mascara. You all know that Lancôme's Monsieur Big Mascara was traditionally my favorite ever. I've been using it for probably 2 years or so. I received it through Influencer, which is a company that allows influencers, bloggers alike, anyone of the sort, to try products, and it's been a staple in my routine ever since. I have really short, straight lashes, but the Bite Beauty Upswing Mascara, you guys, I'm surprised. Like, Bite Beauty is most known for their lippies, but that mascara is a game changer. Now, I do have it today on my lower lashes, and it is just, ooh, it's perfection. So also along with that, their eyeliner is amazing. I have not worn eyeliner probably 3 or 4 years. I go through phases with my makeup where I want a lot of simplicity, and then I want like lots of glam, but that eyeliner is really, really nice. Once again, I'm so shocked that Bite Beauty has such amazing beauty products besides their lippies, because most of us have used their lippies for years and love them, but check out their face products because their eyeliner and their mascara are really, really great. Okay, I'm so excited for this. Now let's get into the good girl Charlotte. You guys know that I am a Charlotte Tilbury lover. I want to say I first saw Charlotte Tilbury on Pockets and Bows YouTube channel. She raved about the magic cream, which we're going to get to in a few, and ever since then I was just enthralled, and then my good guy Beck sent me over some of their amazing best sellers during Vlogmas, and I've been on a Charlotte Tilbury craze. I'm wearing a lot of Charlotte Tilbury products today, including this lip. I'll link all that information down below. But a lot of times, I know people have contacted me and have said, you know, I wasn't sure that Charlotte Tilbury products were gonna work for me, but it's really for everyone. And I love that the products work on various age ranges and skin types and everything of the sort. So the first item I'm gonna recommend is the Airbrush Matte Bronzer. Now, I'm not wearing it today because I'm trying out something new, but this is the only bronzer I have used for probably 6 to 8 to 12 months. I'm not exactly sure when I got it. It is beautiful. It's matte, but it looks so natural. It provides the perfect amount of warmth. Now, I do wish they would come out with a better range of shades, but I do think they have shades that would work with most people's skin tone. I wear the color 3 tan. It's also refillable. Hello, sustainability kings and queens. So I'm really excited about that. I love this bronzer. Now, the one reason why I think this is the perfect time to purchase it is because it's about $55, okay? That is very, very expensive. So definitely now's the time to check out those pricier products because you really can get a great deal. Okay. The next product from Charlotte Tilbury is their Airbrush Flawless Finishing Setting Powder, and this is a product that I will actually be purchasing. I have heard so many amazing things about this product. Once again, you can do a loose setting powder, you can do a pressed powder, but setting powder to me is essential, and I actually got a sample of this, but it was only enough to use it once, but I loved it, and I love setting powders, and I love Charlotte Tilbury, so this is a product that I will be picking up. I'm not including every product that I'm going to purchase in this video because it would be redundant, but that finishing powder I'm really excited about. Then we have the Charlotte Tilbury Cheek to Chic Blush, and I'm gonna recommend two colors for those of my beauties who are around my skin tone. The first is Walk of No Shame, which is a deep berry blush. It is so beautiful. I love these Charlotte Tilbury blushes because they have a wash of color, but they also have a highlighting center. So that's what I'm wearing today. Not the Walk of Shame, but I'm actually wearing the Love is Your Drug, and it just provides the prettiest little little pop of pink with shimmer on your cheek. Oh my goodness. If you do have deeper skin, this is a pink blush that will work for you. I know a lot of times it's hard to find a pink blush that works with deeper skin tones, but love is the drug is perfection. So those are the two that I would recommend for deeper skin tones. Also, now is a great time to try the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Airbrush Setting Spray. I actually have two of them on my vanity behind me. These setting sprays are so amazing. Now, once again, I'm not traditionally someone who thinks that setting sprays are essential, but this is the one setting spray where I feel I can tell a difference when I wear it. My makeup appears more smooth and actually stays in place longer. Now, once again, I have very oily skin. I also have never found that any makeup is transfer proof, but this does help. So now is a great time to try that out, and they offer it in a full size and a travel size. Okay, next is going to be the Charlotte Tilbury Hyaluronic Happy Kiss Lipstick Balm. In the shade Pillow Talk. That's what I have. Once again, I first saw this on my girl Pockets and Bows. She put it on her Instagram and I was obsessed. Not only because I love Charlotte Tilbury, but because we're in the house more, I don't traditionally wear a lipstick like this day to day. I'm wearing a lip balm. So for Zoom meetings and whatever like that, if I can have a product that gives me a little bit of color without having to do too much, I love it. So these Happy Kiss Hyaluronic Lip Balms are amazing because they feature hyaluronic acid, which is one of my golden holy grail standard products that I think most of us could really appreciate in our routine. Hyaluronic acid is a humectant, so it really helps to draw moisture in. It is amazing, and it's also amazing in your lip care items, so I really like that. The one thing I will say is that it doesn't hydrate after you take it off. So while it's on your lips, it will feel amazing, cushiony, and smooth. It doesn't make your lips feel thirsty, but when I take it off, my lips aren't left feeling like I had on a hydrating balm. So then I just put on my Jack Black Intense Therapy Lip Balm and I'm good to go. Next is going to be the Pat McGrath Sublime Perfection Concealer. And I actually purchased this, I believe, in the most recent Sephora sale or the one before that. This is the concealer that I'm using today. I'm obsessed. I did want to try it for the longest because it's expensive. And I was traditionally using a Too Faced concealer that was very, very thick and full coverage. And the first time I tried this concealer, I was like, oh my gosh, where's the coverage? But this has amazing coverage. It's just a higher quality concealer. So it's not going to be like putting paste on your face. It's going to blend in seamlessly. It's so yummy. If I were running out, I would probably repurchase it. I might repurchase it anyway just because I can get a deal, but that's an amazing concealer for all skin tones. Okay, next is going to be the Pat McGrath Matte Trance Lipstick. You guys know Pat McGrath probably had my favorite lipstick until I tried the lipstick I'm gonna speak about next, but that Pat McGrath Matte Trance Lipstick is amazing. It's very pigmented, it's opaque, it's very smooth on the lips. It's just a thick formula. So if you don't like a thick feeling lipstick that's matte, you may not like that. If you like something that feels a bit more thin on the lips in terms of the actual weight of the product when you put it on, definitely try the Givenchy Le Matte Rouge Lipstick, and that's the next one that I'm gonna talk about. I got this, once again, an influencer, and I will link their website down below. It's amazing for trying out products for free to share with your audience. I received a pink shade, and I'll put it across the screen. I love it so much. It took the place of the Pat McGrath lipsticks. Now, you guys know I love Pat McGrath. Pat has some of the best lipsticks, but the Givenchy matte lipsticks have a thinner formula, so it just feels a bit more comfortable on my lips. So I will be picking up one of those lipsticks during the sale. And the last item in beauty is the Kat Von D. They changed it. It's the KVD Beauty Good Apple Skin Perfecting Hydrating Foundation Balm. And this has been all the rage all over Instagram and YouTube. Once again, this is not a formula that I think would be for me because I have very, very oily skin. But if you have more dry skin and you love good coverage, this is going to be a game changer. So I'll link that down below with a review because I think one of my girls did a review on that foundation as well. Okay, skincare. So first is my Foreo UFO 2. I will link a video I did down below where I reviewed this skincare tool. It is simply amazing. It is a flash mask luxury device. You can do a mask in under 3 minutes. I love it because I know a lot of men and women don't have time to dedicate 30 minutes to a skincare day. They may not have time to go to the spa or the esthetician. This little device gives you whatever masking treatment you want in under 3 minutes. It is perfection. I have a plethora of different masks to use with it, but my favorite is the H2 Overdose and the Glow Addict. I love those two masks, so definitely check out that. Foreo's UFO2 is very expensive, so this is the perfect time to check out your higher priced luxury skincare tools because you get the best deal. And the next item is the Foreo Luna 3, which I actually have. I have it in the combination model, but they have a few different models according to your actual skin type. This is my favorite cleansing brush. If you've been following me on social media, which I hope you are, I will leave my name across the screen. I recently tried out the PMD Beauty Clean Facial Cleansing Tool. I'm not impressed. I'll be doing a review of that this month. The Foreo Luna 3 is my favorite. You all know that Clarisonic went out of business, and I love Foreo because the battery lasts forever and ever and ever. It has really long nubs and it's easy to hold in your hand. The one thing that I don't like about the PMD is it's like waving a wand around. There's too much length in the handle. It feels like an adult toy and I'm not a fan, but the Foreo Luna 3 is definitely one of my favorites. Paula's Choice. I am so excited to see Paula's Choice on Sephora's website now because I've always wanted to try Paula's Choice. So I'm gonna link her page of products down below, but the one product that I hear most about is the Paula's Choice Skin Perfecting 2% BHA Liquid Exfoliant. And that is pretty much like a toner, but it has 2% BHA in it, which is a really, really amazing exfoliant. So I would recommend that or any version of a toner that she has. I've always heard amazing things about Paula's Choice, but I don't know. Sephora, they are my favorite beauty retailer. I love that they have a plethora of reviews, plethora of different brands. So I definitely am gonna be trying a few Paula's Choice products, but that's the one that I would recommend most because I always hear it spoken about on social media. Next is going to be the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask. That is a staple of mine. I started using it last year. I took it from my mother. She wasn't using it. It is amazing at just really hydrating your lips. Now, it's supposed to be used at night, but I use it whenever because, I mean, when you're at home every day, does it really matter between night and day? No. So I really enjoy that mask and a little goes a long way. Also, the Estee Lauder Advanced Night Repair Serum is my favorite anti-aging serum ever. I started using it when I was probably 24. I know a lot of people were like, oh my gosh, why aren't you using anti-aging skincare? You're not even old enough. You guys, you should start using anti-aging skincare whenever you feel is best. And my rule of thumb is if you're manipulating your skin, you need an anti-aging skincare product because you want to preserve your youthfulness. I think specifically in the African-American community, we think that we don't need anti-aging products because black doesn't crack and we wait until we're 50. And by then, there's not much you can do. So if you are younger or if you are just getting into anti-aging skincare products, find one product that does it all. And for me, that's my Advanced Night Repair and it's a staple. Next is the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. Shout out to my friend Amy. Every year during the Sephora sale, she purchases this item. I finally tried my sample size that I received for my birthday a few years ago and it is amazing. It's so hydrating, it's so thick. The only thing I don't like is the scent. I might have an unscented version. I need to look into that, but it's a really hydrating body cream. It's just expensive. So now is the perfect time to try out all the products that you've wanted to try but are just kind of pricey. Next, I found the Clinique Moisture Surge 100 Hour Auto Replenishing Hydrator. I've always heard great things about the Clinique Moisture Surge line. This 100 hour thing is new, so I kind of want to try this product out. Now, you guys are probably thinking, well, don't you have really oily skin? That I do, but because I also have oily acne prone skin, I oftentimes use a lot of products that tend to dry out my skin through clearing my breakouts. So using a hydrating mask is something that I love doing. So I also do want to try this Clinique hydrator and they have a whole line with this 100 hour hydrating product. So definitely check those out. Okay, next we have Charlotte Tilbury skincare. This is another category that I love within Charlotte Tilbury. That magic cream is everything. Now, Because I have oily skin, I use that as my night cream. So that's a way that I'm able to tailor my skincare routine according to the needs of my own skin. A lot of products that are made for the daytime that would just be way too emollient and thick, I use them at night. I love that product. I recently ran out. I shared that in a video on my channel last week. If you did not catch my product empties, I will link that down below. And I'll be repurchasing that magic cream. It's very, very, very expensive, which is why I'm purchasing it now. But my skin craves it. It gives me glow and luminosity. It brightens my skin. It makes it so soft and supple. I'm obsessed. I also have the magic cream in a duo set. I will link that one down below. It's about $10 more expensive than the largest Charlotte Tilbury magic cream, but you also get to sample her crystal elixir serum, which is also amazing. Another Charlotte Tilbury product is the Super Radiance Resurfacing Facial Treatment. I saw my guy Beck review this product on his Instagram, and you guys know that I love a good exfoliating treatment, and Charlotte Tilbury can do no wrong in my book, so that's something to look out for. And the last Charlotte Tilbury product I would recommend is the Instant Dry Facial Sheet Mask, the Hollywood Facial. I'll link my video review of that product down below. That dry, yes, you heard, dry sheet mask is perfection. I did not know what to expect because in my mind I'm thinking, how the heck can a dry sheet mask work? When you watch my review, it's gonna make you want that product. Now I know this sheet mask is very, very pricey, but you can use it up to 3 times, I believe. So it's only like $7 some odd per use. So to me, it's worth it, and it is amazing. Another item that I would definitely recommend is the Ulla Henriksen Lemon Smoothing Scrub. Shout out to my girl Ash. I will link her video down below. She reviewed this product. Now, I would recommend a scrub exfoliant for those of you all who have more normal skin and who can take an abrasive product. I like to use more gentle products. I don't like to use physical scrubs on my skin, but for the right skin type that can handle it, it's amazing. Ulla Henriksen has really potent, amazing products, and I love some of his other exfoliating scrubs, so definitely check that out. Also, The Ordinary's AHA 30% plus BHA 2% Peeling Solution is amazing. This is the one product, if you're only gonna get one thing during this sale, it needs to be this peel from The Ordinary. Why, you ask? It's under $10, and it will give you baby's bottom smooth skin. It's a red liquid. You leave it on your face for 10 minutes after cleansing your skin. You wash it off and your face will feel squeaky clean, like literally. That product is amazing. I purchased it maybe a year ago. I recommend it to everyone. If you're just looking for one product to resurface your entire face effectively and cost effectively, that's your girl. I also want to try the Ordinary Salicylic Acid 2% Mask. I've heard that that's great for getting blackheads out of your nose. I have lots of trouble with that. The first place I start sweating is my nose. It's genetic. So I do have lots of blackheads on my nose. So I do want to pick that up. It's always out of stock though. And also, if you're oily and you have acne prone skin, try the Ordinary's Niacinamide 10% plus Zinc 1%. I love that product. I purchased it in the last Sephora sale in November. The only thing is it decreases the oil production for me. So I couldn't use it in the fall and winter. But now that it's basically like summer in Atlanta, I definitely want to try using my niacinamide again. Niacinamide is great for protecting your skin against the elements. It's also great for oil production and blemishes. If you have problems with that, I would definitely check that out. The last skincare item is not really a skincare product, but hair grows from your scalp. So we're gonna count it all the same. This is the GHD Classic 1-inch Styler. This is the flat iron that I'm currently using. You guys know I cut my hair last year, and Lorena Bobbitt is just everything. Gotta fluff the bob. I recently switched back from a titanium flat iron to ceramic, and it was day and night. I will never go back to titanium. Babyliss Pro. My GHD flat iron is amazing. It doesn't have a temperature dial. It's supposed to have innovative smart technology that adjusts according to your actual hair. Now, I don't know how accurate that is, but I know when I use that flat iron, it makes my hair so incredibly shiny, and it helps to lock in moisture, which I need. So definitely check out that. Okay, you guys, the last category is going to be fragrance. One of my favorite categories. The first two items that I'm going to recommend are staples during the Sephora sale. I'm always mentioning these products, and then I always watch videos from some of my faves, and they're like, oh my God, I didn't know this existed. I've been trying to tell the guys and the gals for years, Sephora's fragrance samplers. They are amazing. It's basically a kit that you get samples of fragrance, and inside you also receive a scent certificate. So you get to try out every fragrance inside, and whichever one you like, you exchange your certificate for a free bottle of fragrance. Now, that's not the best part. The best part is that, let's say one of the fragrances is $65 retail. This sample kit might be $50. So you're already saving on that product. So I would say if you want to gift somebody with a fragrance, check and see if it's in one of those Sephora fragrance samplers, because you get it for a discount and then 20% off. That's a no-brainer. So if you're in the market for a new fragrance, or if there's one you want to restock that's in this kit, this is the time to get it, because you can always save money and then you get the sale price, like you can't beat it. So definitely check those out. There's one for men, there's one for women. I think the one for women actually features little bottles of fragrance, so it's a great gift. This would be great for Mother's Day and Father's Day. Keep it until then. I always, always, always recommend the fragrance samplers. They are the best gift idea ever. The next fragrance that I'm going to recommend is Versace's Dylan Turquoise, and I have not yet made it to Sephora to try this fragrance, but I love the original Dylan Blue, which I'll also link down below. The turquoise is supposed to be like your spring and summer version. I just feel like it's going to be so aquatic and amazing. I don't know if any of my girls have done a review on that fragrance yet, but I'm really interested in that. So that's a great pickup for spring. Another one that I always want to try, but it's just so expensive, is the Killian Love Don't Be Shy. This is a staple. Everyone talks about it. It's supposed to be the scent that Rihanna wears. Now, I don't know how true that is, but it's supposed to smell like marshmallows and candy and oranges, I believe. I want to try it, but now is the time to pick it up if you are interested. And once again, that is Killian's Love Don't Be Shy. Okay, next is Gucci's Gorgeous Gardenia. I love Gucci fragrances. The only problem is that a lot of them don't last on me. Now, I know that varies from person to person, but gardenias are one of my favorite flowers in terms of the scent. And this fragrance is so beautiful. So if you love a gardenia scent, you will love that fragrance. Next is Chloe's Eau de Parfum. And this is a staple, a classic staple of mine. The only thing I don't like is that the bottle tarnishes because it is real silver, but Chloe's Eau de Parfum is like that fabulously chic, very classy and sophisticated woman who goes to the country club during the day, and she just brunches, and she's fabulous, and she's everything. So definitely try Chloe if you have not. And the last fragrance is Tom Ford's Soleil Blanc, and that is like a classic staple for spring and summer. I have never tried it, I don't think, but I may or may not be getting some version of this scent during the sale. It's supposed to be an amazing beach scent. I recently got the Tom Ford Soleil Neige and I'm obsessed. Actually, I got a sample of the Soleil Blanc. It's a perfect beach scent. It smells like coconut and sunscreen. It didn't last too long on me, but it's a really nice scent, and maybe you'll have better lasting power. But now is the time to get Tom Ford fragrances. I will link a page with all of his scents down below, because they're so incredibly pricey, but getting to save up to 20%, it's definitely worth it. So you guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I am so ready for the sale. I'm going to be up the moment the sale goes live to place my order. I have been waiting for this moment my whole life. No, I've been waiting for this moment for months. I want some new goodies. I'm craving a Sephora haul. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Once again, thank you so much to Sephora and Magic Links for sponsoring this video. Happy shopping, you guys. Like I said, I will leave all the information concerning the sale, the dates, and everything like that down below. And stay tuned to a Sephora sale haul. I will link that video down below when it becomes available. I'm just so excited. And also, if you're gonna be shopping online, shop through Rakuten. I will leave my link down below. It's always right below the break in my description box. Rakuten is an amazing site that gives you cash back. I've been using it for years. It's free money. Okay, so thank you guys so much for watching. I love you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.